14 of the Treasure Tumblers curriculum on bars, starting with our amethyst class for our two-year-olds. These guys are going to do lift a prop to the bar. So they're going to hang underneath the bar with straight arms. Mom or dad is going to put a prop in between their feet, and we're going to ask them to lift the prop and touch it to the bar and back down. This is one of their more advanced skills, and so this might be a little bit tricky, especially for those 2 1/2s, but the kiddos that are closer to 3 definitely need to be getting this down. After the first bar, they're going to head over to the rings where they're going to do a straddle hold. Again, we're going to have them hanging with straight arms, not bent arms, and ask them to lift their legs out to the side. Those older 2s, we can ask to start working on some of their K readiness and counting to 3 as they hold their legs out and straddle. After rings, they're going to come over to the uneven bars, and on the low bar, these guys are going to do a barrel glide. So again, this is going to be assisted with mom and dad. We're going to put the barrel underneath the bar, have them place their feet on the top of the barrel, and mom or dad can put their hands on top of their kiddos' hands to make sure that they don't slip off as they do their glide swings, stretching out and coming back. After their glide swings, they can climb into the pit and then slide out, and that's it for our two-year-olds. Okay, on to our three-year-old Opals. These guys are going to be working on their jump to front support on the bare bar. This is also one of their more challenging skills and something that they need to have by the time they're done with the three-year-old class. And so at this point, since we're close to the end, they should at least be able to jump up and get their belly on. They might not be able to get their arms straight, but we want them getting more comfortable with being on top of the bar and holding their own weight. And you might need to drop the bar for them to be successful at this, and that's totally okay. After jump to front support, they're going to come over to the rings where they're going to do their straddle hold. And these guys, since they're a little bit older, we can have them start counting a little bit higher and maybe give them a count to 5 to try and get to. After their straddle hold, they're going to head over to the uneven bars. And on the low bar, they're going to do their straddle swing. So they're going to hang with straight arms and lift their legs up so that their toes are on the bar outside of their hands in a straddle position. And once they're hanging there, they're going to bend and straighten their legs to start creating some swing and try and keep their toes on the bar as they do a couple leg pumps. After that, they're going to go into the pit and slide out, and that's it for our three-year-olds. Okay, on to our four-year-old Peridot kiddos. These guys, on their first bar, are going to work on shoulder shrugs. So we're going to have them up in front support, and we definitely need to be working for those straight arms. And we're going to have them get their shoulders all the way up into their ears in short shoulders. And then we're going to have them press the bar and try and get their shoulders away from their ears and press the bar down towards their knees. What we don't want to see is have them piking. So when they're pressing up, we don't want them to stick their butt out. We want them to push their ribs in to try and get into a round shape. So we want short shoulders and round shape as they're doing their shoulder shrugs. After that, they can head over to the rings where these guys are going to do a straddle hold as well. And again, we want to start increasing how high we're asking them to count. So depending on the ability of your students, you can have them count to 5, you can have them count to 10, you can have them try counting backwards, you can have them try doing the alphabet. After that, they're going to head over to the uneven bars. And these guys on the low bar are going to do their hot dog. So we're going to have them make sure that they remember to turn sideways before they place their hands on, one hand facing each direction, and then get their feet up. And these guys need to try and do 3 chin-ups and touch their nose to the bar 3 times. After their hot dog, they're going to head over to our last single bar, where these guys are going to do support swings. The cheese mat is here for the upper 2 classes, and so you can use this as something for them to aim for with their feet, where they do their short shoulder pike hold, and then extend and try and get their feet to hit the mat. Or you can just pull the mat out of the way so that it's not even a part of their station. After their support swings, they're going to go into the pit, slide out, and that's it for the 4-year-olds. And we are on to our 5-year-old Jade kiddos. These guys on their first bar are going to do jump to front support, and then they're going to do short shoulder pike hold and a leg swing with an extension behind them. So, with a shoulder shrug. So we want them in their short shoulder pike hold, and then extend their legs back, and then push into a round shape. So we're creating all the shapes that we want for a cast without actually having them leave the bar. So we want them to go in slow motion for that. If they start swinging their legs too quickly and they're not pressing on the bar, they could roll forward into a forward roll. So make sure you're really enforcing with your kiddos to hit their shapes and hold and not swing their legs very quickly. After their shoulder shrug support swings, they're going to come over to the rings where they're going to do an L hold. So you're gonna hang with their straight arms, feet out in front, and try and lift their toes up into an L shape. It's a pretty advanced and tough hold, so giving them a small achievement that they can attain would be great. Asking them to count 1 to 5 or back. backwards 5-1. That's a pretty long time for them to be holding that position. After rings, they're going to head over to the uneven bars. And on the low bar, these guys are going to do their traveling hot dogs. We want to make sure that they start on one end of the bar, turn sideways for their hands, get their legs up into their hot dog, and then walk their hands and drag their legs as they move to the other side of the bar. After that, they're going to get on the mat to reach the high bar. And on the high bar, they're going to do arch hang, straight body hang, hollow hang. So they'll create all three of their shapes. They'll start in a straight body, and then they'll pull their ribs in to get their feet in front, go back to straight, and then push their ribs out to get their feet behind. And we want those shapes to come from the upper body and not from the hips. After the high bar, they're going to head over to our last little bar, where they're going to do a cheese mat pullover. So these guys, we're going to have the cheese mat almost underneath the bar, play with their head hanging off, and their nose underneath the bar, and then they're going to lift their toes up and over, and they might not be able to come up if their head hits the mat, but then they can come back down. And that's just creating the hip rotation of getting over on their pullover and helping them keep their arms bent. After that, they can do the pit, slide out, do the monkey bars, and they're back to the beginning, and that's it for our fives. Okay, on to our advanced diamond class. These kiddos on the first single bar are going to work on their stride support and reverse grip. We'll probably need to have the bar pretty low for most of the stations that each of the levels are doing. This bar is going to need to be low. You may need to drop it all the way down for this station or get a mat for them to stand on. But they're going to stand here with one leg over, put their hands upside down and backwards on the bar, and then they're going to jump up and shift their hands to the top and then try and hold themselves in support off of the bar. That support is pretty challenging, so just getting them comfortable with being in this position, even if they're on the bar, working for straight legs and straight arms is a good challenge for them. Kiddos that feel pretty comfortable up here, asking them to lift up and into that split position is just going to get them even more ready for their next step. After this bar, they're going to head over to the rings, and they're going to do a hollow stand into a glide swing. So we're going to have them hold onto the rings and pull back so that they're in this nice round shape, and then lift their feet up and swing out as far as they can with a straight body, keeping their ribs in and their toes up instead of letting their ribs pop out with their feet down. We want that nice hollow position as they extend. After the rings, they're going to come over to the uneven bars, and on the low bar is going to be their spotted station where you're spotting them through their back hip circle. So in the last weeks, we've done just the first half into that hollow position upside down. So again, we're going to have them go through that position. You can have them stop there, switch your hands, and then lift them all the way through the rest of their back hip circle. If they're doing a good job of holding their body in a tight, straight body position, you can have them go full speed all the way through. And if they can do that, keeping their body straight and their arms straight as they come up, we can have them add a few casts before they go into it. After the low bar, they're going to go up to the high bar, facing the low bar, and they're going to do their swing hops. So you guys have spotted this with them before from the rib cage. Now this is the second time they're doing it. So you can hold onto their wrist and make sure that they're not going to go flying backwards. And if they're doing a good job, you can have them try it without your spot. After that, they're going to come over to our last single bar where they're going to do a captain hook swing and try and get up to a front support. We have this cheese mat here, so you can use the cheese mat for them to get up. Here, the mat would be more in this position, and they would be facing this way, and they'd get in their captain hook, and then they could hop their foot up the mat to help them get up. The bar is too low for me to demonstrate it, but what it would look like if they didn't use the mat, they would be in their captain hook and create a swing, and then they would push up to their front support. So they could hop their foot along the mat to help them get up to that front support position. Or you can take the cheese mat out and just have them try it. After that, they can do the pit, monkey bars, back to the beginning, and that's it for bars this week.